Oh, hi guys, Kevin here. Welcome back to another car build and tuning episode on Forza Horizon 2. This is a car that I just looked in my garage. I was looking for the car and I was just like, where is it? Why have I not made this yet? So, sorry that I'm not using your guys' suggestions, but this is a personal car that I want to make and I want it in my garage so badly. So, next episode of the car build and tuning episodes, leave a comment below saying what car you want to see. Next episode, but until then, I'm going to be doing this episode, and the one with the most votes up will get absolutely destroyed, aka tuned. So I am trying to work out what the hell I'm doing. Okay, nearly swore then, but then let's go over here to the festival services. It's not very far away, but yeah, a driving game where I don't like to drive. So let's jump into the hub. We can jump and buy this car. Not if we go into garage though. We can't do it if we go into garage. So let's come out of there and into auto show. And yeah, I appreciate all your guys' support. It's been crazy recently. That looks sick. But yeah, it's been crazy recently. The support on my Forza Horizon 2 videos. Obviously, I am uploading other content as well, like FIFA, etc. That some people don't really like. I do understand, but I enjoy playing those games, so that looks sick. I enjoy playing those games, so I'm always gonna play them. And what the hell is that? Nissan ID Nismo. That could be a future car build. Oh my god, that looks really strange. Okay, so it is Nissan. And it is an S15, as some people do know, and in-game it's called a Silvia Spec R. So let's have a look, see if there's any nice paints in here. I do like that one, that looks pretty sick. That orange one looks very good actually. We could do a top secret. But I'm kind of just feeling that one from earlier, kind of like that, with the orange involved, that one. It looks kind of different. It's got like a paint splat. It looks pretty cool. And when that's slammed on nice rims, that's going to look absolutely solid. So yeah, an S15. I don't even know why it's not in my garage, to be honest. I don't know why it took so long to get there. But I'm putting it in my garage right now. And it's happening. You ain't stopping me. So yeah. Let's jump out of the auto show. And let's jump straight into the garage. I keep saying jump. Like, why? I'm sat still. I'm not jumping anyway. So let's jump into the garage. Hey, I just said it. I said let's jump into the garage. Okay, so I'm going to stick with a stock engine. Drivetrain is what we won't have to change, seeing as it is already rear wheel drive. Aero and appearance. Okay, is there any nice body kits in here? Should we put a top secret body kit on? Should we do it? Let's do it. Yeah, let's do it. Yeah. Okay, that failed because there's no top secret now. Because it is the wing. Let's de-wing it. Let's do it. Or we could put a crazy wing on. Nah, let's de-wing it. It looks pretty clean. De-wing, so let's go for that. Let's do the top secret rear bumper. And hopefully top secret side skirts. Yeah, there we go. So that is the body kit on. Bonnet, I kind of prefer that one with the logo on it. So let's go for that. Tires, I'm going to stick with stock tires for now. We can change that if we do need to. 235s on the front would be perfect. And on the rears we can go 255s. That seems absolutely fine. Yes. Okay, so that's that. Smithers. I have no idea, I've just lost all track of what I was just doing. Okay, multi-piece rims. So strange, I am so strange. Okay, some rims that suit this car. Gone for the multi-piece kind of rims. Do they suit it? A little bit. Do like those on it. Let's have a quick look through here though. Them. Let's go for them. Let's do it. Let's not change our mind. Let's just jump in and put on those. Yeah. Okay, no change in your mind. It has happened. Okay, rim size. We want a nice tile wall. Let's go for 18. It's not too much of a tile wall, but it eliminates most of it, which is all a gravy, baby. Let's chuck that on. And we've got that dish. Got dish. All the old school people know what that means. Got dish. Oh yeah, baby. We're coming back. So yeah. Onto the drivetrain. Everything in the drivetrain is going to be race. So go through and chuck on. To be honest, kind of tempted not to do that. Even though it does boost acceleration, that will help. Yep. Let's do it. Race transmission is on. Oh god. Race driveline and race differential we want on as well. So there we go. That is all on, gravy, all on gravy. So, enter platform and handling now. Let's chuck some, let's not do race brakes, let's do street brakes. Obviously, I've started putting lower brakes on my cars, mainly because when you're tandeming, trying to get close to someone, etc., when you're on race brakes and you tap the brakes, it's a lot harder than, say, having street brakes. Obviously, you can keep stop brakes if you want to as well, but that is all up to you guys. You can put race brakes on if you're not going to be doing tandems, etc., and you just want to stop the car a little bit more quicker. So, as we're going through here, everything in here is going to be race, and that looks absolutely sweet on those rims. Wow, that really suits them actually, because like the gold effect, it goes with the orange, but there's also like the black bonnet kind of works with it. I don't know, it just works with that color. It looks pretty sick. So yeah. Good choice of rims there. Okay, so what weight are we running? 1,000 kilos? I thought it'd been a lot heavier than that. That's crazy. So, race air filter, race exhaust. Let's do race camshafts. That should push it up to 360 horsepower. I'm feeling around the 500 horsepower mark should be absolutely sufficient for this car. 452 horsepower, the race turbo one. And let's chuck on intercooler and oil and cooling, and that should hopefully put us up to the 500 area. Let's just say area. So 480 horsepower there. What we could do is chuck on one more upgrade. It could push us up to the 500 horsepower mark. So if we go for pistons and compressions, this should do it. There we go, 504 horsepower, spot on. Running 1,000 kilos, so that's gonna be a drift pretty sweet actually. Yeah, that's some nice distribution there. That's very nice. So let's jump out into free roam. Let's go to a nice area. Let's tune up in the airport. In the section where I've done my tandem video. So let's jump up there. This is probably one of my best drift areas, to be honest. I like the smoothness of it. I love the variety in it as well, and it's very, very good for tandems. Nice transitions where you can get close to people, and some very long corners where you can get very close to people as well. So that's pretty sick. So yeah, this car's pretty much stock, as people who play Forza Horizon 2 do know. It's so easy to tune drift cars on this game. You could just drift quite literally out of the box. You put a lot of power into it. Oh, gear 3 is a little bit of a struggle. Let's go into gear 2 just to test out these stock settings. As you all know, I don't really, really like drifting in gear 2. I don't know what it is. Ever since the start of Forza, like Forza 2, all the way through to now, I've always drifted in gear 3. It's just that gear. I just know once I'm in that gear, this car is going to be spot on. So I'm going to try and get the gearing down to gear 3. But at the moment, I'm going to leave the gearing how it is. What I am going to do is camber this up, because it feels a little bit too grippy for my liking. So let's go into here. Front seems fine on the steering wheel, so let's just up the tire pressure in the rear to get less surface area on the floor. Gearing, we could change it a tiny bit. It was on 3.65, so let's just go to acceleration. Let's go 3.75. Oh god. Alignment. Pretty low, actually. I swear it's normally a little bit higher than that as stock. So let's chuck that on. Toe, we could go minus 2. 0.2 minus 2, sorry. Caster, 5.5. Anti-roll bars. Let's take up the rear a tiny bit to get closer to the front. Springs, pretty okay, but I like my cars quite stiff. So I'm just going to up this a little bit. All the way to stiffness, ride height all the way to the bottom, damping in the front can come up, bump stiffness in the front can come up, and differential 100%. So as I did say, Horizon 2, you can tune cars very easily, you don't have to make too many changes. What you have to do is just get the tires spinning nicely, with a nice stableness, and you're away basically. You can just drift how you want to. Okay, so gear 3 is still bogging down there. Kind of surprised by that, actually. So we're going to have to shorten the gears up a bit, I think. Spins up very nice in gear 2, which is a good sign. Let's give it another run, just in gear 2. See if we can feel any issues with this car whatsoever. I feel like I just need a little bit more grip in the front. It seems a little bit all over the place. So that's pretty stable once you're sideways. So it's more of a problem getting gear 3 to work now. I think that's where the problem is going to lie with this car. So I'm just going to get some little bit more grip in the front here. But what I am going to do is I'm going to go to the more towards the negatives on the camber section. Just because we want the wheels spinning up a little bit easier than they are. So let's take the camber up in the front a tiny bit. And go to minus 3, let's try that. Okay, anti-roll bars and all this junk is fine. So let's jump out of there. Gearing, we could go a lot shorter. Just to get gear 3 working. So let's just go to like 4.1, see if that gets gear 3 in its zone. It should be fine, but we can easily change it if we need to. Okay, gear 3 seems absolutely spot on now, which is very, very nice. It's holding some very nice angle. Oh my, did it. Okay, bogged down there. So gear 3 is not maybe spot on like I just said, but if we just shorten the gears a tiny bit more, I think it's going to be absolutely fine. So, as soon as we chucked on loads of camber, tire pressure's got to come down. It felt too like it was on ice, basically. So let's go 28, and let's put this one on 30. In the front we can come down a tiny bit more actually. Alignment, that's fine. What did I come in to change? Gearing. So let's go down in the gearing. Let's go 4.25, see if that's fine. But it does seem very weird, this car. Like the gearing as stock is very, very weird. I don't know now if the gearing is going to be too short. Okay, so it feels very nice sideways. What I am going to do is I am going to chuck on a lot of camber on the rear. We can come up in the front as well. But I just want to see if gear 3 doesn't bog down if we just do like say that. And let's just see Because obviously with camber, you're putting less tyre surface area on the floor. So in theory, there's less grip, which in theory means tyres spin up easier. Sorry. So that slid quite nice through there. This car loves that last corner there. It absolutely loves it. Okay. I think that camber on the rear has really actually helped. Because one thing this car seemed to be struggling with was just getting those rear tyres to spin up as they should. So, I don't know, I'm just going to leave the camber as -5 to be honest. I don't know, that really worked. But what we can do, take down the tyre pressures in the front a smidge. And yeah, I think that's going to be fine. The gearing can go back a little bit longer to be honest. If we keep making it longer until the point where it does actually struggle to spin up around that tight corner, I think we should be quids in. So with this amount of camber on here, okay, so up to there it struggles to spin up. So let's make it shorter. So this could be like trial and error basically. So let's go to 4, because obviously we want the gears as long as we can get them before they start bogging down, etc. So the longer we can make them, the better it will be, basically. Because you can stay in that gear for the very long corners and the very short corners. But it's just mostly trial and error, just trying to get the gears spot on for what you like. Okay, so it didn't bog down that time, which is good. There's a lack of grip in the front. There's an absolute lack of grip. What I'm going to do is I'm going to up the camber just to match the rear. Sorry, but then what I am going to do is I'm going to take tire pressure down a lot. Let's go down to like 24. See how that performs, because obviously there's a big difference there in between the front and the rear. So the rear could power over, but we're going to try it. So that spins up fine. Very, very stable, which I like. Don't seem to have those spinning out issues at the moment, but that could all change. Okay, so it just bogged down there. Especially when we're in tandem, etc., we do not want it bogging down at all. So this is very, very strange, to be honest. Very strange. With -5 camber, it should not be bogging down at all. Maybe in my tire whips, I've put a little bit too high. Maybe, I don't know, but I don't think so. It should be fine. But let's go into what's it going to go into? The gearing. And let's go more towards acceleration. Again, 4.1. Like I said, it's just going to be absolute trial and error at the moment. Feels pretty nice with the very, very low tire pressures in the front, though. Feels like it's got that extra little bit of grit that we needed just to throw the car into the sideways in this. It's directing us where to go, which is very nice, but it's also got the slidiness of the rear as well, which is pretty sick. Thank you. Okay, this is feeling very nice now. Especially as it's raining as well, and it held angle like that. It's crazy. So it doesn't bog down on that corner, which is what we was aiming for. Ah, the rain caught me off guard there. But it's feeling very, very nice, this car. I've always wanted an S15 in my garage on this game, but for some reason I just never got around to making one. But now I've got one, I will be pulling this out a lot, I think, because it feels very nice sideways. I'm not spinning out, which is a good sign, so you can get some clean runs going. And yeah, that's that. So yeah, if you guys want to leave a comment saying what car you want to see next episode, we can try and tune it up, get a very nice car on the go. But for now, that was that. What I am going to do is upload the tune onto the storefront for you guys to download. You can just go onto there and download it. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. So let's save this. Let's just call it Drift. Drift. Oh yes, Drift. And there we go. So that is going to be saving, uploading, doing its thing. And just go onto the thing, search, load a setup. Just search my gamertag in the creator, which is Kevin Toll, the same as my YouTube, and you'll be able to download it pretty much gravy, 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 gravy. So, hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you did, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys next time.